Jenna with Jenna Regan Photography. I am a pet photographer in the Dallas-Fort Worth area, and I thought it would be fun to share a little bit of a behind-the-scenes look into how portraits are created. So many times I get clients that when they first come to me say, "Well, those are beautiful portraits. I love what you do, all that good stuff, but my dog's never gonna look like that or act like that or be that easy to photograph." And I always reassure them that there's a lot that goes into creating these portraits, and it's not as easy as it looks, but all that falls back onto me. I take care of it for my clients. I guide them in the process to make sure that we're going to have successful photo shoots, regardless of the personalities we're working with, and that there's things that I can do before, during, and after to make sure they do get these images they really want. So one of those things is the editing, and I do all my editing myself. So I'm hand touching each image that my clients end up purchasing, and that goes forward with an ordering. So I'm always keeping in mind that this image is going to be, printed in perhaps a large wall art piece, maybe in an album, things like that. So I'm going to want it to be perfect. So the devil's in the details, and I'm 100% behind that saying and follow that belief personally and professionally. So here's what I do when it comes down to the editing. So this is the original image. It's a beautiful portrait of Sophie. She's an adorable golden doodle, and I don't want to take anything out of the portrait that makes it special to her. However, there are things that can spruce it up to make it an art piece more so. So here's what I would do. I went ahead and circled the areas I worked on. Just a little detail, but it makes a difference. Just that black corner up there at the top. We don't need that. That's just part of the background, and it's definitely not something that's adding to the portrait. So I cleaned that up. I kept the rustic nature of all the rest of this because it's wood and each piece is different and it's unique. And I don't want to take away from that. There's not anything really worth cleaning up because it's just part of the background. It's so minimal and it just adds texture and some character to it. So leaving that alone. There's these little stray hairs here that overcross her eyeballs. Oftentimes, if I have a dog such as a golden doodle that does have that happen during the portraits and we're printing an image, I'm going to clean that up. We don't want to have anything that disrupts the eye contact that we're making when we're viewing the photo and looking at her beautiful eyes. So just cleaning up that little hair makes a difference. I do leave the rest of the scraggly, adorable, fluffy hairs because that's just golden doodle characteristic and that's part of what makes Sophie her. I'm sorry. So that's just one of the little areas I tweaked. Over here, I did not tweak the hairs. I just went ahead and brightened her eyeballs a little bit and actually did that on both just to give it a little more pop, and a little more definition. Here we have her beard. Adorable. I don't want to change too much, but I do want to clean it up a little because she had a drink of water and she's got some little dark hairs that are kind of distracting and kind of clumpy and just not as perfect as it could be. So those areas were all cleaned up. Right in here, I also cleaned up this leaf. She gathered it, she picked it up. Sometimes I've had this happen where the client likes it and we leave it in. I had an adorable dog this past fall that picked up a really big leaf and it was, half the size of her face and it was just funny. And my client loved it because the dog loves leaves. It fit with her personality. So we did not take that out. That's not always the case, but in this case, it basically just looks like a piece of debris. So that's why I wanted to take it out here. Also, we have the leash. This is a typical thing for my clients. We often leave the dogs on leash. It is a debatable thing. I always take it on a case-by-case basis, but overall, I advise my clients that that is usually best and that the portraits they see on my website and on my different social media platforms, pretty much 8 out of 10 times the dog has been on leash, even if there's multiple or even if there's just one. So it's just an element of safety, peace of mind. And sometimes the dogs just need that way to stay connected to what we're doing and not want to go off on their own adventure, because we can spend more time, calling them and tracking them down, over and over again during a portrait shoot than is necessary. So this way, she's safe, we're connected, and everybody's happy. As you can see, she's even smiling. So that is what I did there. And then the end result with the additional edits I do every time, my special edits that I always do, are right here. So this is what makes the final image of, print worthy, in my opinion. like I said, we kept a lot of the scruffiness. That's just who she is. I didn't want to take away from the characteristics, but I wanted to clean it up a little. So to give you a quick reminder on before and after. One more time, before and after. So a lot of times these edits are so little, in the end, subtle little changes, but they do make a difference. And that is something that I'm always looking for ways I can tweak things. A lot of times my clients don't even realize I do it. Sometimes I tell them during their ordering appointments, look, this is some of the things I want to change. Are you okay with this? And other times I already know for sure, like the leash is going to go and we're all on board with that. But I'm always trying to find ways to really make a difference in the final result, to really find the things that we don't need to have that take away from her beauty, such as here with Sophie, and just make an image that's perfect in the end that we're all loving. So I hope you like this. I'll try to do more here now and then, just some more before and afters, but this is a little peek into what goes into each photo shoot. Thanks for watching.